All right, I'm sending the Sony Handycam down the well, just far enough to see where the pitless adapter connection is and what side it is on, because I think when I pulled it up, I have the distance right, but I don't have which side it's on, so I got to send this down. And it'll be good for a little inspection anyway, for what that's worth. All right, so the last time I had my camera pointed to the side, which is too close, obviously, and I couldn't really tell what I was doing. So I'm going to change it and set it so it's pointed straight down. And hopefully I'll be able to tell my orientation somehow when I'm down there. So let's see what happens. All right, here we go. Take two. Black tape here. All right, so here you can see this is where they spliced them on with shrink tube, and there we go. Just gonna take and hack this off right here. Glasses on so I can see what in the world it is I'm doing. Oh my. Oh. Boy, that doesn't like to strip off of there very easy. Try a different one, maybe it's because I got that thing on.
Wow. Pretty big contraption you got going on here.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
How many feet am I seeing right now? How many feet am I seeing?
I think you're seeing about maybe down to 10 or 12 feet. Just don't drop anything down there because you'll have to drink it later.
That'd be a bad idea to drop something down there.
All right, you get the idea. Okay, so these here are the shrink tubes I need to put on here. And now you're probably wondering why in the world did I do all this before I even change the pump. And the reason is because by the time I get to changing the pump and start hooking up the wire, I'll forget to put the shrink tubes on until after I get the wire spliced. That's just the way things work in my world. So here we go. We're just gonna set these on here right now. before I forget. It might be so hot out today that these things shrink without a heat gun. I don't know. Righty tighty, lefty loosey. I have no idea what's good and what's bad with this. No idea. Okay. Time to put the new one on here. Don't ask me whether this is a good one, bad one, indifferent, whatever. But I bought it at Fleet Farm. And it is what it is, three wire. Made sure it was a three wire. Let's open up the box here. This is it. It is what she is. Got 1¼-inch connector. Looks like it's got a built-in check valve right in there. Okay, that's what that looks like. Installation instructions. Set those aside. I have. Look at this here. Look at this here. I went and bought shrink tubing and put it on there. And there's shrink tubing right there. That actually looks like better shrink tubing than what I bought, maybe. Although I think I bought their brand of shrink tubing. Okay, so there we go. More shrink tubing that I didn't know was in the box. I wasn't going to open this until I knew what I was doing here. I got a control box here. Submersible motor control. Alright, so got all these goodies right here. Okay, so here we go, putting the pump on. Now with this thing being plastic, I don't know how tight how tight I can go, right? I don't think I want to go too terribly tight, but I guess you got to go tight enough. Get the feeling like I shouldn't go any tighter than what I can hand tighten it. I don't know if it says in that instruction or not. Maybe I should look before I get to how tight to do this. Oops. Which makes me a bit nervous. Since this is plastic, how far do you go?
Good question.
I'm sure I could go till I break it. I don't think that would be a problem at all. See, I can still turn it there by hand.
Yeah,
What's that?
Yeah, turning real heavy yet.
Yeah, but do I really want?
You really want her heavy though.
Yeah, how heavy? Thing won't come loose down there, will it? You know what I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take that rope that I have, I'm gonna tie that rope onto here when I let it down.
Oh, okay.
I'm gonna leave that rope in there.
Okay.
And leave that up to the top of the well.
Yucky.
Just as kind of a fail. A fail safe.
Anything on there that's missing.
You just put one of these in from one side and the other one in from the other side. Right? Put that on there.
Now you gotta put a sleeve over them, or have you already put the sleeve on?
I got the sleeve here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Right tool for the job here or not. That shrinks down onto there. Seems big.
Yeah, they shrink down pretty good.
Hopefully that. I don't know, there's some kind of a goop that comes out of there too. That must have something in there that seals it that way. I'm gonna call that one good and just leave it be here. There's kind of a goop that comes out here. That must be the stuff that seals. And I think I'll put some tape around it too.
Yeah.
Right. So I'm gonna try and start in the center again.
I guess it can't hurt to be doubly safe, can it?
No, I don't think so. Unless we get in your pump or something.
Well, they had tape going all the way up and down this whole thing before, so. Maybe I should tape down here too once. Just, I don't think that would hurt. Cut that off nice. And then I'll just go and tape the entire length of it.
Oh, okay.
That's kind of how they had it before, so.
Oh, yeah.
Spots along here. Every so often. I taped up on either side of this pitless adapter here, just to keep it out of the way, hopefully.